Okay, welcome all. This is the lecture 2, session 2. And before going to the break, we were discussing a very important point that we are here to make intelligent agents. And we have seen that such an agent need to be defined using either tabulation or we can write a program for that. When we write a program on tabulation, we have seen that the percept sequence that it uses to take the action may be a big problem to explore the size of this particular table, and therefore it's not a good idea to write a table, although it looks like that when the small number of options we have, we can write a table because table is going to be fast. We have seen that this is not a good idea, because even with a small number of small size of the possible options, that possible history that it takes to take the next action may be a big issue. Then we have seen that even if we design such a system with a tabular thing, we seen that large number of agents are possible because we can fill the table into the exponential number of way. Out of those exponential number of ways, we have to find out which one is better. So this understanding would be only satisfied if we can define a performance measure. Then we have talked about that this performance measure, although we are going to design a good agent, we should not focus on the agent itself. We should focus on the environment, that what is the behavior, what is the effect on the environment that this particular agent is going to create. Okay. So when, and we have also seen that defining this effect is not that easy. It could be a difficult problem in itself. But when we, let's assume we define this, then we can have a perfectly understandable good event. Then in the last slide, we have discussed that if we write a good program that can clean the system, we have taken an example of the vacuum cleaner agent, and we have seen that if we change the performance measure from one measure to another, even then the first agent that was the same agent which was actually good becomes bad. We have also seen, we have also discussed that the perfect agent is not possible, because perfect agent would be that agent that has been provided all the information, all the conditions that are going to happen in front of you a priori. Then only it can take the best decision, perfect decision. The perfect agent is not possible, and we are not going to discuss, we are not expecting to build a perfect agent. Okay. So this is perfect for to make a perfect agent. We need a omniscience agent that knows the actual output of all his action. This is also impossible. Okay. And that one very important part of the agent is the information gathering or the environmental discovery. Whenever agent is there, he want to discover the environment so that it can take the proper action. The information by information gathering, we means that an information uses its sensors to get all the information. For example, if we have an agent that want to cross the road, then what is the information gathering? It try to see both side of the road and try to get the understanding that where the other vehicles are, and this understanding is the part of the information gathering. When we start the agent, when we put the agent into the initial configuration, it may also reflect some prior knowledge because he has started from this thing. It could also be a knowledge, and in between, after when the agent is started, it moves some around or performs some of the operation. By this, it is changing the environment, and based on the changing information, based on the interaction with the environment, it can modify its actions, that in the what it is going to take into the future. Because sometimes it may not be a good idea to fix the all the things that the agent does a priori. So it may be possible that the agent can adapt to the scenarios. Okay. Although some of the prior knowledge could be provided, but it is a better agent would be such that by itself improves its knowledge. Okay, So an autonomous agent, because most of the time we want an autonomous agent, learns to compensate for the partial or incorrect knowledge, because when we have put the into the initial configuration, that may be, that may not provide all the information about the environment, because into the real life scenarios, what is going to happen, who can provide that, what is inside the environment. When the agent itself goes, then only he have to learn that what is inside the things, because a priority cannot fix all the things. Just assume a driverless car. When it goes on the road, nobody can tell a priority that this is going to be scenario to you, because what is in front of it, it is always a new scenario. So an autonomous agent would learn that what is the environment and then behave accordingly. Okay, and from the very high level, abstract level perspective, we can say that the task environment is the problem which is being solved by the rational agent. So we have an agent that is going to solve a problem, and the problem is the environment. Complete environment is a problem. The environment means all the road networks is a problem, and the autonomous driving car is wanted to move the car from place A to B, and how to move that is actually solving that particular problem. To define a task environment, you need to define these four things. We call it PEAS, P's. Then these are the performance, environment, actuator, and sensors. And based on the requirement, we can change actuator, we can change the sensors, we can change the environment, we can change the performance. Okay, so we have seen that when we change the performance, the same agent becomes bad or good. So these four things we need to define. Consider the case of autonomous taxi, means autonomous car. So what is the performance measure? What could be the performance measure of the autonomous taxi? So I told you that this would be outside from the performance of this car itself. It would be, we want to see that what is the effect on the environment. So try to see that performance measure would be what is the effect on the environment. So you, and the effect of the environment would be how safe the car is, because it is moving, but we want to see it should be safe. I got a question. Let me just take it. Sir, is the rationalism is the measure of perfection? I told you that perfection is totally useless concept. It is a single, it's not the rationalism. It's a single concept, that what is the best that you can do. The best thing you can only decide that if you know that what all the things are going to happen in your life. Okay, let's assume that you are a human agent, you want to perform the best. How can you perform the best thing if you know everything that is going to happen in your life? Nobody can see that what is going to happen at the later point of time. Therefore, it's a bad idea, it's an impossible idea. But the idea is there, that what is the perfect, if somebody has died and now you want to analyze that what were the perfect things that he had done in his life. So this only you can tell if you know if the person has died. Then you can analyze, you can tell that he had not taken admission over here, he had gone over there, he had opened this thing, then he may be perfect. But at the time when the person was taking decision, it was not shown that what is going to happen at the later point of time. Is it clear? Tanmay, is it clear? Okay, thank you. So I want to, the performance measure, I would define the performance measure. One is a safer, how fast it is, because sometimes we want to be fast. In the environment, if you want to go from one place to another place, you should be fast. It should be legal. You should, if you can walk on the right hand side of the road, you should only walk on the right hand side. You cannot tell that I'm very fast, but I'm moving into the wrong direction. This is also not the right thing. Okay, so these are all the things that you can perform. Okay, how comfortable the ride was. How to maximize the profit, means you want to reduce the cost of the going from place A to B. I have again a question. Let me just say, sir, two failures are accounted in the autonomous cars. Can you comment on these incident based on our concept being discussed here? Two failures. Can you please mention those failures? Okay. So I want to see these things. And very important point is that these things, safe, fast, legal, comfortable, maximize, that they are actually not the things on how the agent is working. We see how safe it is outside, that how safe it is into the environment. This is what the important thing. What the environment in which it is telling? okay, road traffic, pedestrian, customers, means because these are the things which are when you are running your vehicle, you would be seeing roads. This is your environment. What is the traffic scenario? Means how, whether other vehicles are, whether pedestrian are, where are the customers. Customer means, let's assume it's a taxi, then in the taxi the customer would be booking the things. Okay, the question is, two failures are accounted into the autonomous car, and those failures are the fatal accident, means there was some accident and another was the car, let's assume that the car had crashed itself. So these things how would you define, here? So both the things come into this particular term called safe, that how safe it is. So how safe it is to the roads, how safe it is to the customers which are sitting inside, people who are sitting inside. So therefore you define the safe. Safe is the performance measure. So you say that that particular software, that particular agent which were driving the car was not safe, and you give less marks. And if you have an agent that doesn't perform these bad, any accidents or the crash, you say that that agent is a better agent. Okay. The question is it because of the learning problem of the agent? Again, the question is it because of the learning problem of the agent? Reason could be many, because I told you that I'm not going into detail that what is learning and what is there. I'm just talking about it is an agent. It may be a software failure. It may not be the learning problem. It could be the brake has failed, as happened the accidents with the humans also. So we are not going to detail into the how the things had been happened. But my point is that thing has been happened. Okay. So environment, we are talking about environment, that is clear to you. Actuator, what are the actuators? How the agent can change its behavior. So it can use the steering, it can use the accelerator, brake. Okay. It can use the signals that actuators could be, it can signals means right turn, left turn signals. It can blow a horn. It can use a different display. These could be actuator means it can wave hand, etc. Similar kind of some display it can produce. So these are the actuators by which it can change its behavior. Sensors, what could be the sensor? Autonomous taxi, camera would be there. Sonars to understand that what is the distance of other objects nearby. Speedometer, what is the speed? What is the GPS, where I am? Odometer, okay. Engine sensors and keyboards. So these could be means, there could be some human person also, he can be arranging the things. So these could be the sensors. Okay. So we have seen an automatic robot one, and similarly there could be a software agent, and the software agent most of the time are very rich and they have the more things available. As I told you that when a software agent, since they don't need much of the things, they could be very effective, such as they need what is happening on the keyboard, what is happening onto the mouse, they have access of the files, they have access of the network things. So sometimes therefore these are the software agents, they want to manage and perform some operations. Okay, what is the meaning of rich? Okay. Rich means they have lot of, I'm telling the software agent exists in the rich and unlimited domain, which most of the time they, whatever they have, it is not limited, because how many files they can access is maybe unlimited. If the internet is provided to them, then they can have the unlimited amount of the things. So most of the time, because into the, whenever we are developing a hardware based agent, they have limits because they can only see some of the parts. But software agents are more capable, and most of the time they have an unlimited kind of things, means whatever processing power they want to use, they can use. Okay, so let us see some example of the things. Let's assume that the agent is a medical diagnostic system, and then what should be the performance measure? I mean, how good the medical diagnosis system is. So we can see that how healthy the patients are. Okay, it reduces the cost of operation and cost of medication, etc. What is the environment? Patient, hospital staff, these are the environment. what are the actuators, display of the questions means of what are the what problems you have. It will be throwing to the patients and then getting the answers. Test, what are the tests it does, diagnosis, different kind of diagnosis equipments, treatments that it can provide, a reference that it can provide. What are the sensors? Keyboard entry of the symptoms. Okay, findings, patient answers, findings, what are different findings are and what are the patient answers. So this is similar way of the you can perform this. Sensors, actuator, environment and the performance measure. See another one, satellite image analysis system. Let's assume you have a, you want to analyze the satellite image. What are the sensor? Means what is the input that you are going to get? Color pixel array. What is the environment? Downlink from the orbiting orbiting satellite. Things you are getting from there. This is your environment. You from there, because that is the perspective from which you are seeing all the things. What is the performance? Correct image categorization. You can tell that this is a field, this is a mountain, this is lake, this is sea. And what are the actuator? Display of the scene categorization, because actuator means on the something, some places you want to put the label that this is what are the things. So when you put the right label, this is what your actuator is. Part picking robot, there is a robot that is picking some parts, some things, and you are putting the right things onto the conveyor belt. Some, let's assume that there is a conveyor belt, items are coming one by one, robot is picking the right things. Okay, what are the sensor? Camera would be there, joint angle sensors would be there that want to sense that is there something behind it and it picks it so that how much I have booked it, etc. And then you want to see that what is the environment, conveyor belt is there. Bins are there where you want to put the things. And what is the performance measure? Percentage of the part that is to find out correct, because it is, it was going to pick the right things. The percentage of the parts that are correct, so this is the performance measure. Actuator, what are the actuator? Joint arm and the hands, because it is going to use those things to grab the particular item. So these are the actuators. Okay, refinery controller. So temperature, pressure, chemical sensors, these are things because in the refinery you have placed this. So you want to see the what is the temperature there, what is pressure, chemical sensors, etc. And environment is the refinery and various operators that are there. And what is the performance? Performance is purity, how pure your output is, how what is the yield, how safely you are going to perform the operation. Actuators, what are the actuators? Because we are opening the pump and closing the valves, displays and heaters, etc. So these things are actuators. Okay. Interactive English tutor, then for that you want to, what is the sensor? Keyboard, because person is typing something. And the environment is set of a student testing agency. This is the environment you have. And how good you are, how to find out the performance measure, a student score on the test. And actuators, display of exercises, because you are displaying the new questions and suggestions and corrections that these are the problems they can improve. So we have seen that to define a particular agent, we need to define these things. And we have seen some example where you can define. So let's see some properties of the environment. I'm just seeing in the PEAS, this particular example, PEAS, let's just see that environment, how different kind of environment could be there. I'm just focusing on this because environment is a very important part. If you change the environment, your performance is going to change and the different kind of needs, items need to be, agents need to be designed. The environment could be fully observable and partially observable. Most of the time we have partially observable environment because when the agent is sitting, is standing somewhere, it can only see the things nearby. He cannot see all the things which are there. Okay, into the driverless taxi also, if you are a driver, even if you are a human driver, you are sitting inside the car, you can see that what is in front of you, some part what is behind you, but you cannot see everything that is around you. Okay. Hence, there could be some fully observable state, such as when you are playing a game of chess, then if things is fully observable, you can see everything that is there. So most of the time when the environment is small, you can have the fully observable, otherwise you don't have the fully observable, partially observable is there. single agent, multiple agent. It may be possible that when you are developing the system, you have only single agent available into the environment. Sometimes multiple agent could also be there. And then again the question comes that whether when multiple agents are there, what they are doing. Okay, so for example, if you when you are playing a cricket match on the mobile phone, what is going to happen? There are you are let's suppose that you are throwing the ball, or you are doing the fielding, or you are doing the batting. Then other agents are also there. So you would be shown as an agent over there, and you are playing the game. Okay. So other agents may be competitive, means they may be want to win. For example, if it's a game of chess, with two and multi two agent game you start, one would be playing with the white and the other would be with the black, and they would be competing, means to win. They would be cooperative. For example, if it's a game of football or cricket, so they would be cooperating, means they would be throwing balls for each other help. Communication, they can do the communication, multiple agent can do the communication, single agent cannot, he only have to take the decisions. So these issues comes when you have multiple agents, and you can take advantage of that. Deterministic versus stochastic, this is also a very important thing, that real life scenarios are most of the time stochastic. Okay. So means what is going to happen into the next minute, nobody knows. So therefore, we are into the stochastic environment. A deterministic environment is where we know that if this particular operation is done, then what is going to happen. Okay, such as when we play the game of chess, it is a deterministic environment because we know that whatever we are going to put, this is going to happen. Stochastic, whenever you are going to take the action, it may be possible that you will not take that action because of various different region. Okay, next state is uncertain. Sometimes you don't know that if I'm going to put this, what the next state is going to come. So in the stochastic setting, next state is uncertain. There is some uncertainty evolved. So most of the real life scenarios, when we want to perform something into the real life, they are stochastic. Okay. So you understand this episodic, episodic or sequential. In the sequential, you want to perform one step, then another step, then third step, fourth step. You go one step by step, and you perform some operation. What is episodic? In the episodic one, you perform say five set of operations at a time. Okay. Then second another five set of operation, another five set of three operation. This is called the episodic. So what is the example of any episodic thing? Do you have any example of the any episodic one? Do you know any episodic thing? You know that if let's assume that you have a robot that want to bring something from the rack and do the packing. Let's assume that it's Amazon or a big company dispose system, and where you want to, whenever a person orders for a particular item, a robot goes there and picks that item from the store and packs it and sends it and disposes it to be sent for the person. Okay. Then how it does? There is some episodic things involved, means the person goes. So these things are one step. Let's assume that the going forward five step is a one episode. And for picking the item, means for the picking item, the item should go in this way. This is what the one episode. Then it catches. Catching may require five, six steps. These are happening at the same time. Then it brings it back and then it put into the box, and box is being closed and wrapped around, and a label is put on that, automatic label has been put. So you can see that there are few things which are set, and every time it is going to happen. So we can say that this is one episode. And similarly, you can find out that there are multiple episodes. Okay. So for example, into the game of Atari, when there is something falling from the screen and you want to hit that to go and throw and cut something from the board, what is going to happen when it comes and strikes on your striker, when the ball comes and comes near to the striker, then again what is going to happen? It's a episodic thing. Means same thing going to happen from here to here. Many other times it may have happened. Okay, but in the sequential, every time the things are going to change. Such as when you are playing the game of chess, then you have next step, then you can only go for the next step. You cannot say that I'm running these five steps one by one. No, because your opponent is going to give you another thing, so you have to change your strategy. Okay, static versus dynamic. In the static, dynamic means things are not changing. In the dynamic, things are changing. Okay, your environment is fixed, but and here in the dynamic, the things are changing. For example, if I say that I'm going to put the robot somewhere, and robot would find out his part to come out of this particular castle. So this is a kind of static environment where things are static. I put the robot, it would figure out how to go ahead and it comes out to me. But if I say that robot have to find out his path into the crowded area, then the things are dynamic because everything is changing in front of him. So he can take a different way to go ahead. Discrete versus continuous. Sometimes you go, your environment is such that you in one, it goes into steps, in the first step, second step, third step. In between you cannot find how the things had gone, okay. But into the discrete, for example, when you are moving with a car, taxi car, if you are place A, place B, every point you can find out, okay. I have a question, sir, please repeat the episodic and sequential fact. Okay, let me once again tell. See, episodic and sequential. In the sequential, we have sequence that I'm going to do this, then I'm going to do one by one, and each the steps are actually atomic steps. But sometime you can club the atomic steps and to make a episode that, for example, packing an item. How to pack the item? Take the item from here. Put it into the box, wrap the close the box, wrap the box, pick the label from here and put and then throw it. So these 7-8 things are going to happen as a single operation. Okay, if robot want to pack something, he would stand up, go to a particular rack, pick a particular item, bring it here, and then these 7 things, 8 things which are needed for the packing, for example, picking the box, putting inside, closing and wrapping and putting label and throwing, all these things are actually have to happen every time. So this is called one episode. Okay, sometimes you see this kind of episodic behavior. As I told you in a game example, I told you that let's assume the Atari game where the ball is moving from top to down. So top to down movement would always be there in the same way. This is the episodic part. The same thing going to happen. Okay. In the sequential, every time means one by one, you are changing, or you are taking something and moving it around. So there is no episode. Same thing is not going to be repeated. There is a difference between static with dynamic. Okay. Deterministic and stochastic. Please try to see. Static and dynamic means, I told you, let's assume that you have a castle and I tell that robot is here, he want to go from place A to B, how he should go. So in that system, since he is inside a castle and nothing is changing, he can find out the path. But if I tell you that robot is in a football field and he want to go from place one to A to B, and now let's say the game is on and he have to move, but what is going to happen? Since things are changing, it's a dynamic system. In a static system, things are actually fixed. Deterministic, stochastic, again I want to tell you, in the deterministic, okay, next step, whatever you are going to take is fixed. Means given in this scenario, if you are here, you can take this decision. But sometimes you are going to have a probabilistic nature. It means with a very high probability I would take this decision, but there is small probability that I would take this decision. I could take the wrong decision also. Sometimes it is required, okay, that you don't go for the deterministic one. Means every if this is the scenario, this is everything, if I fix everything and I tell that what is the action to you, then in that scenario whether you are going to take the same action or you can change the action. This is the question is, if you can change the action, because why you can how you can change, because all the possible out of all possible action there is a probability associated. If I say that this is a highly probable, most of the time you would be taking that particular decision, but sometime you can also take the another move. So either if I say that everything fixed, the decision is fixed, it is a constant function, then it is a deterministic, otherwise it's stochastic. So I think that it should be, is it clear? What's this? Okay, deterministic versus stochastic means either the system could be deterministic or stochastic. Either the system could be episodal or the sequential. Either should be static or dynamic, discrete and continuous, are known or unknown. Most of the time system environment is unknown, and sometimes system environment could be known. Paper ID, you know that these things are going to happen. Sometimes you don't know about the system. The system is evolving, system is changing. We don't know. Okay. So what is the distance? Can anybody tell the what is the distance between dynamic and unknown? Okay. Dynamic and unknown is this. Let's I say that there is a as I very recently taken the example that let's assume that there is a game of football is going on, and I tell that find out the route to go from place A to B inside the inside that particular field. So what you would do, you would find out, because since things are dynamic, but it is known to you, what is known to you, that there are only 12 people or there are only 20 people who are moving in this particular direction. So you know the system, that this is the area from this place you have to go, and these are the people we are actually moving. So this is known system, but it's dynamic, it is changing. You understand this? Very important to understand, because dynamic and unknown, sometimes people get confused. So this is the difference. What is the unknown? You don't know that how many people are there. Okay? Okay. Any questions? So let me just take some example. Crossword puzzle. If you crossword puzzle, it is observable. Yes, fully observable. You know everything. If I give you crossword puzzle, you know, the thing, words are written, and you have to find out that is there elephant, cow, and whatever things are written. So fully observable, you can see everything. Agent is single, you are only one who is solving this. It is deterministic, yet deterministic. And it is episodal, no, it is sequential, because one by one you are solving one thing. You cannot tell that I would find out the elephant, then and then this thing. It's sequential, one by one item you are finding. It's static, because it's, things are not changing. Whatever is written there is there. Discrete, yes, one by one there, everything is to one cell. Chess with the clock is also fully observable. Multi-agent, because two people can play this. Deterministic, things are not changing. Okay, episodal or sequential. Sequential, ek chal aap chalenge, next the person would do, then you have to find out what is the next move. Static, semi-static, discrete. Taxi driving, you cannot observe everything, partially observable. I told you that when you can see what is in front of you, but after that particular person what is there, you cannot see, because you see that there is a car in front of you, but after that car there is a small dog, you cannot see that. Multi-agent, multiple cars are there. Stochastic, because you want to, why is stochastic? Because sometime it may be possible that in a scenario, it is up to you that whether you would take the turn or not take the turn. It's stochastic because when you want to go from A to B, it is not 100% required that you follow that path only. You can take a different path also to reach the same place. If you say it is sequential, it is sequential. One by one things are coming. Okay. Sequential. Dynamic. Things are changing, nearby cars are actually changing the scenario. Discrete or continuous, you see the continuous, because between two places, all other places you were there, it's continuous. So similarly, you can see the medical diagnosis, image analysis, part picking robot, refinery controller, interactive poker. So there's a lot of things are there. And I suggest you that please go through these things so that you understand very in detail. Okay. So now we would talk about that, we have talked the properties, now we talk about the agent, that how you make the agent. Okay, we have talked much about the environment of the agent, let's talk about that, how you are going to make the event. To make the event, you need two things: architecture. Architecture means underlying the hardware that you use, and the program. Some people is asking, can you share the book reference? I told you from the day one that it is the book is Russell Narang book, and the name is also was there into the last slide of the last class, and today also every class, whatever the references are there, it would be there onto the thank you slides. Please go and see that. Okay, in the last slide you would find that same book I'm going to follow. Okay, the agents are the architecture for program. Means to make an agent, you need some hardware, and then you write a program. The general setting, let's assume that you are making a hardware agent, so you would be making having some hardware, and you would be putting some software on that. Okay, so table driven agent, if you have agent that you implement using table driven, so what is the algorithm? Algorithm is this: percept means the agent sees what is outside, then what it does. Append the percept to the percepts means whatever earlier he has seen, he appends this current observation to that thing. Because I have told you that the in the general setting you think that agent is taking the decision based on whatever it has seen earlier. So percepts means whatever it has seen earlier, and this current thing it appends it. Now it sees that these are all the things that I have seen. Now I want to take the decision. So it goes and sees, it goes and accesses the table. And in that table, it applies to see this percepts and try to see that what action I should take, and then it take the action. Is it clear? And we have seen that it is not possible because of the combinatrics that we discussed very recently, and it is very difficult to write such a table. Okay. And then when we are going to make the agent, there could be four kind of agent possible: simplex reflex, simple reflex, model based, goal based, and utility based. So we will be talking detail very soon. Somebody is asking that it is similar to state machines, correct? Because whenever we are going to make a table, for every step it is decided that what action I am going to take. It is similar to the state machine, but the issue is that devising such a table is very difficult. Okay, so we are going to one by one see. You got this idea? So we have understood that having a table based agent is very difficult, not possible. Therefore we would be making a program based agent. The program based agent could be four types: simple reflex, model based, goal based, and utility based. Okay, so we are going to see one by one. Let's see the simple reflex agent. So this agent, inside the question mark I had unfolded some of the thing. Let me just tell you one by one, very easy these are. So we have environment. From the environment, there is some sensor with the agent, and therefore from the environment you get some percepts. And actuators are also there, that whenever it have a decision it can tell, and therefore the action can be taken on the environment, that you know. So when the percept comes from the sensor, then the simple reflex try to see what the word is like now, because he have find out seen that what is outside there. So this is the input, and using this input it understand that what is the word looks like now, how the word is now. Okay, when he understand how the word is now, then it what action I should take now, because he know that the word, this is the situation of the word, then what action I should take. So how to take this action? There is some action condition, condition action rule means there is some if condition available. Say that if this is this, take this action. If this is this, you take this action. For example, into the driver's less car, there could be one thing that if the car in front of you has the red light on into the back side, you know, it means that he have applied some brake, then you should also apply the brake. Is it clear? So this is a condition. Condition action rule would tell that if he is applying, if the car next to you is applying brake, you should also apply the brake. If that traffic sign is red, you should stop. So these kind of things are there. It would try to see whether the next person have the red line, next car has a red light on, or I am at the crossing where the red light is on. It would try to see and then try to find out the appropriate that action pair over there and use that action pair to decide the what should be my output, and this output is given to activator and the actuator actually take the action into the system. Simple reflex is very easy system, but the important part is this, that in the most of many other time very complex systems even use these kind of logic because they are very fast. Okay, whenever we need a fast action, for that we need to have a simple reflex agent. So even if we have a very complex system, there would be a small part, the very critical part, they are implemented using the simple reflex agents. So you can write the algorithm in this way, that simple reflex agent take the percept, current prospect, and important thing is that it is not going to see that what has happened earlier. So most of the history is actually ignored. Okay. So interpret, then it want to interpret the input, means see the percept and try to find out what the state it is, because it has percept is just, let's assume that there is a camera, from the camera some input is coming. So for interpret input means it want to see that what is the what the, this thing means. This means that I am on the crossing and there is a red light on. Okay, then it find out the rule match. It try to find out is there any rule. There rules means all the rules are there. It try to see that is there any rule that applies on this thing. So rules may have if then lot of if then conditions, and then it find out okay this is a rule that is suitable in this particular state, and then it find out that what action I should take and that action is returned. Is it clear? I think simple reflex model is one of the basic one, and therefore you should not have any problem. Any questions you have, please let me know. Okay, so okay, that's clear. So let's go and see this more practical example, model based reflex agent. So here this is the second one, is a model based reflex agent that have a model. Okay, what is the model? Because sometimes just seeing that what is outside is not enough. You want to see that what I have done very recently, because you know don't know the what is the state of the environment. You see that what is the thing, but you don't know what is the state, but what has been happened earlier. You may not have the complete understanding of the environment, but even what I want to say that sometimes you may not have the complete understanding, but even you can a small understanding of the environmental state would be useful. Okay, so you want to maintain. So what the world is like now, you want to understand whenever the percept is coming to you, you want to go to see the in what state I am. In this state, if this is the condition, okay, then I would try to see. Okay, so now your decision will be more complex. You want to know, for example, if you are driving, what could be the state? The state could be that who is sitting behind you. If he is a prime minister sitting behind you, what does it mean? It means that all the roads may have cleared, and therefore even if you see that there is a red light on the street, you should not stop. So you should see that what is the state you have. If your state is such that you can the different decision you need to take, what I mean to say. Okay, so first this model based reflex agent have a model, that is model is this state, and also the model reflects that how the world evolves, means how the you want to develop an understanding that from one state to another state how the world changes. Okay, you are into this state, but this state to this state how the world changes. So there should be, you want to get the understanding of this. Who is going to give you the understanding? It's not a question I am addressing here. It may be a learning procedure, or it may be hard coded to you, means if the things are not changing, it could be hard coded. If the things are changing, you have to learn about how to learn, we are talking about later. But from one state to another state, how the things go, this is an important part. And also what my actions do, means if in this state I take this decision, what is going to happen? Okay. Whether I am going to change my state, but apart from that, whether I am going to get the good thing or bad thing, whatever, what other effects are there. So based on these three things, in what state I am, I would see, go and see that if I take this particular action, what is going to happen. Then I would decide that what is the most appropriate action over here, and I would tell this particular what action I should take now. Okay, then again we need to have consult the action table, condition action table rule, that the table tells me that this is the appropriate action that you should take, and I would take in that action, and then actuator would take that action. Is it clear? Is it clear? Sir, is it mean that there are multiple transition possible from state 1 to 2? No, multiple transition from state 1 to 2 mean nothing, okay? Because I would take an action, I would change the state. So from one state to another state I would be going. Multiple from one state 1 I can go to the various states. That is fine by taking a particular decision that is there. So this is the algorithm, simple reflex agent. You have seen recently that what is the percept, and then you want to update the state. Means you know that I have a state, and if I take some action, what is the action? Action would depend upon the state and percept, and then what is the current percept, and what is the model mean? What is my understanding? Model means what is the understanding of the word, and then based on that you find out that what should be my next state, what is my right state. Then using that state, that rule, you want to find out that what is the right rule that I should use, and then you find out what is the action related to that rule, and then you take that action. So I think it is also very simple. In this slide, while you are explaining model based reflex agent algorithm, say simple reflex agent. Okay. Thank you very much for pointing out this. This is again a type of mistakes over here. Okay, because I am making my slide by myself, so it may be there may be some type of errors. Thank you very much for pointing this. Okay, so you understand this, that this is the how the model based reflex agent goes. Is it clear? I would correct this and let you know. Okay. Thank you for pointing this out. So I have simple, because most of the time we do now the same things, we copy and paste, and therefore there is some error. Okay, so you understand this model based reflex agent. Let me see the third type, that is the goal based agent. Okay, so the goal based agent is this, and where the same thing is there. And what is the difference between these two things? The one thing that is going to change is that instead of the condition action rule, I'm going to tell that I have a goal that I want to follow. And what do I mean by goal? Okay, the goal is important. Because why the goal is important? Because when I am going to take the decision, I can take multiple decision based on the goals. Let me tell you what. That let's assume that it's a driverless car. Okay, you are moving on a path. So and you reach to a particular crossing. Then you have to take the decision whether you should go straight, take the right, take the left. Then which decision you would take? You take the decision. Maybe if you want to go very fast, okay, you may take the highway. But if you take the highway, you may be reaching fast, but in that way you may be spending money, because the people are having toll taxes, and you may be having more. You may be spending more money. So if money is not important, you can take that particular way, okay. But if the goal is to minimize the money, you would go to another way that is shorter, but there may be a lot of traffic, and you may be spending a lot of time. Let's assume you have a lot of time, and now your objective is to minimize the money. Your goal is to minimize the money. You understand? So this is also important, that sometimes when we are going to develop the system, it is not only the thing that we want to complete the task, but apart from the task there should be some goal, and this goal is important. Correct? Again, the same thing, same setting is there. From the environment you got the percept using the sensors, and then what you want to understand, that what is the word and how it changes, and what is the effect by things. Then you want to find out that what it will be like if I take the action, because various actions are there. So you find out that the various actions are suitable to me, then I would try to take that action that maximizes my goal. So it requires search and planning, and that is very important. Okay, next one is a utility based agent, and utility based agent is a more general one than the previous one. So everything is the same, only here only one thing is added, that how happy I will be in such a state. Okay, so here only goal is not the goal, is the look, read this line, utility evaluate how good it is. Okay, so sometime Sometime you may have taken the because of your goal, because you want to minimize that thing, you have taken this particular path. But how good it is on the environment, okay, how good it is from other perspective, there could be some other perspective also. So utility actually not only take care of the goal, but it also take care of the other things, okay, for effect on the environment, okay. For example, if the goal is to go from a place A to B, then the utility could also include how cheap it is to reach the goal, okay, from various parts, okay. The utility evaluate how good it is, how cheap it is to reach the goal, and it is most likely try to maximize the expected utility. So we want to whatever utility is a single word that have multiple things in it is, and from very high perspective it is utility is only the understanding of the environment and the goal. You can also think one thing that there could be multiple objectives when you are doing something. There could be multiple objectives, and when you have multiple objectives, then there would be some trade-off. For example, when you are giving the ride to the person, so the let's you have a taxi. We are just talking on the same thing that you have a taxi. There is some customer sitting inside. So you want to have two goals. First goal, you want to take more money because the person is paying you the money. It would be the more money given to you. And the other thing that you should give the more comfort to the person. So if you are want to give more comfort, what would happen? You have to spend more. Okay. So you spend more means your profit is going to be reduced. So there is a trade-off. If you increase one thing, the another thing is going to have a problem. So when multiple things are there, then this particular utility actually comes into the picture and try to find out what the percentage and weights are given to the system and how you can manage those things so that appropriate action could be taken. So here what the word is like now you understand, then what apart from all the action you choose that which particular action is, then you try to find out the action which actually how happy I would be in such a state. So you want to make yourself very happy, so therefore utility gives you this handle so that you can manage a trade-off, you can manage the other objective. What action I should take is then decided using the if it's logic, and then actuators are actually on. The very important part is this, that these kind of agent can handle uncertainty because they can manage a trade-off, therefore they can manage the uncertainty also. Any questions? Next part is the general learning agent. So we have talked about the four kind of agents, and we have only talked that when you have an agent, how it performs its operation. We have not talked about that how you can train it, because initially it may be possible that the things are not good, but with the training the things become good. So when you want to build a general learning agent, means the agent is learning also and improving also, then this is the overall picture. And in this picture, this learning agent, what is the learning agent? This learning agent is the complete this box. So this particular box is inside this box, okay. So general learning agent, inside the general learning agent, this complete thing is there, okay. This agent is inside this general learning box, okay. So what would happen? So I had just taken out the sensor and actuators outside. So from the environment it gets the things, and then it performs whatever four kind of learning agents we have, they can perform the operation. So this loop you understand. Apart from this loop, there are three more important things that are put over here to make the system that can learn. Okay, what are these things? One is the performance standard, means from the very environmental perspective, you say that this performance is important, and there is some critic that try to see that how the system is performing, because every input is given to him, he analyzes what the state of the how the overall system is performing, and he try to see and give the feedback that this is the bad happening or you are not doing good into the system. For example, the driverless car, if you take a rough move somebody outside from the environment is some other driver is actually screaming on you. So the critic can tell that okay, this move was looks bad because I have seen somebody, he was not happy with you. Moves. This is the feedback, and from this feedback the learning element, that is a independent element, that try to see that how can I incorporate this feedback, and based to incorporate this fact, what it does, he changes something because he sees that what are things knowledge means. So whatever, what is the knowledge, this particular condition action rule, they are not knowledge. They try to see that what knowledge inside is and try to give new things, new if in conditions over there, so that the condition action pair is improved. So new kind of things are actually given. Okay, and then comes the third part, that is a problem generator, and a learning goal is given to him, because why you are learning, because there could be some reason for the learning. So if you want to learn to be more adaptive, if you want to learn to solve the problem in the lesser time, what is the learning goal? There could be some different learning goals. So based on the learning goals, it generates the appropriate kind of scenarios, and then it consolidates whatever the knowledge is available over there. So this is the overall structure that of the general learning agent, where everything into the agent is into the learning agent, and the learn. Okay, I think I have done again a mistake that because just copy pasting it, this particular mistake here came. Learning element, I have put both the places on learning element. Okay. So this is the actually learning element. This is I am telling that this part is actually the complete agent, and therefore I would call it performance element. Okay, it's not the learning element, it is the performance element. Okay, again I am telling that there is a typing mistake, and this is the performance element because this is performing the things, and this is what the the agent was doing. And learning element is this, which is actually telling that understanding what knowledge it has, and then it is giving some kind of task, so that see that how can you can modify, and new kind of things is his condition action table is being modified. So again I want to point out that this is the performance element, is not learning element. The name should be different. I'm only telling that there is a typing mistake. Okay, just copy pasting because it has happened. So you understand that these are the three important part. One is the critic, that sees that what is happening into the environment and gives you the feedback. Learning element try to see that what is there and what need to be changes, and based on the goal it provides that these are my goals and this is going to happen. Problem generator modifies this the table so that the system adapts better. So this is how the general learning element goes. So this is the last slide I have. So somebody was asking that what is the book. This is the AIMA chapter 2, Russell and Narong book, Modern Approach to Artificial Intelligence. Okay, so you just see this book, and the details are there into the first slide also, first course lecture slides also. So I would be closing this session now, and I would be open to the questions, and things would not